Let's do this. What if I told you that Jay-Z and I are similar? You wouldn't believe me, right? I know I'm not a rapper, and unfortunately, I'm not married to Beyonce. But I feel like we have some common attributes. Jay-Z grew up in one of the housing projects in Brooklyn, New York. And he always knew he had a thing for rhyme. And so in 1995, he tirelessly tried striking deals with record labels. But no one would sign him, which then led him to making his own record label called Rockefeller Records. He then later signed a deal with Priority, releasing his album Reasonable Doubt, which then hit platinum. You still don't get the connection between me and Jay-Z. Let me elaborate. Jay-Z had no idea what he was gonna do when he was growing up. He didn't know he was gonna become successful or famous. And he probably felt really hopeless and confused when no one would sign him. If I was in his place, I would have told those record labels that they were a bunch of losers and didn't deserve a talent like me anywhere. And I would have probably felt really confused and sad too. I can sum up this whole situation in one word: lost. Who here has ever felt either physically or mentally lost? Merriam-Webster defines lost as unable to be found, not knowing where you're going or where you are. It's also a TV series that came out in 2004, if you remember. Lasted for a really long time. But for real though, what does it mean to be lost? Is it where I'm gonna go to university? What my career is gonna be, what I love, what I hate, what kind of sauce I want with my fried chicken, what song I'm gonna listen to next, what I stand for a person, or what my favorite color is? For me, it's all the above. I panic all the time because I feel like I have no clue what I'm doing. I feel like I'm Daenerys before she became the mother of dragons, or before Harry Potter found out that he was a wizard. But every person goes through this. Whether it's a middle schooler who's finding a clique to join into, or a high school senior who's looking to go to university, or a 22-year-old who just graduated and is wondering if they're gonna get the corporate job or not, or even a 50-year-old who has a desk job and is rethinking their life decision of not becoming an artist because of the financial risks that come with it. So, let's go through the list of how I'm lost, because honestly, currently, I'm lost, and most of the time, I feel like I'm numb, and I'm having a midlife crisis, and I'm just 17. So here's the alphabetical list. A, I'm lost as a friend because whenever my friends are upset or crying, I suddenly malfunction. I have no idea what to do. And so I awkwardly pat them on the back, and I tell them, it's okay, you're gonna be okay, stop crying. And I try to make some jokes, but I feel like they're really bad because they start crying even harder. B, I'm lost as a granddaughter because I can't make my grandparents understand that no matter how many times I straighten my hair and no matter how many times I brush it, the next time I take a shower, surprise, it's still curly. C, I'm lost as a student because I can never excel at math, okay? No matter how many times I do the mixed examination review at the end of the chapter, and the concept is so simple, and I don't get it, and I can't fit the knowledge I have into this letter grade in order to pass. D, I'm lost as a person because I don't know what I stand for. Is it what my family stands for, or my friends stand for? I don't know. E, I don't know where I'm gonna go to university, okay? People are applying, and people are writing their personal statement, and people are done applying, and I'm not doing anything. Most of the time, I'm anxious, and my stomach hurts, and my heart pounds, and I'm silently freaking out because everyone knows what they're doing, so why don't I? Why am I such a mess? Why can't I see around me? Why can't I see in front of me? I feel like crying, and I feel numb, and I feel tired. It's like I'm in a never-ending state of panic. It's like I'm sleeping and I'm falling into a black void of nothingness and I don't know when I'm gonna crash. It's like I have a compass in my pocket and when I come to take it out, it's broken and I can't tell north from east, from south from west. From this tsunami of words and emotions, I conclude that being lost is a continuous state of life. We will always be lost to some degree in our lives. But more than that, anxiety has a negative effect on our bodies. Fun fact, did you know that when you start panicking or if you're anxious, you're more likely to perceive neutral smells as bad smells. And that is because your emotional system gets mixed up with your olfactory system in the processing stream. And so, if someone next to you has perfume on and you don't mind it, but then you suddenly start panicking, you'll think they smell awful. And now, you won't, not only will you be panicking, but you'll also be gagging too. More than that, anxiety has a list to go by to destroy our body one cell at a time. The worry and anxiety that comes from trying to find yourself and rushing to know where you're going leads to your fight and flight response becoming activated, which then releases a stress hormone called cortisol into your bloodstream. And if this stress hormone doesn't go away after a while, anxiety starts taking off. Heart attack, stomach ulcers, muscle tension, insomnia, fatigue, nausea, constipation, and or diarrhea, and the list goes on, my friends. And so I believe that we as the human race should stop believing that we need to find ourselves right now, pronto, or the whole world is gonna crash. As Christopher Poindexter once said, here's to the children of social disease, to the children of knock 'em dead stereotypes and razzle-dazzle rebellion, to the children who don't know what they want and get judged for it. Here's to not knowing. Here's to not having to. And for a long time, I believed that I had to find the whole picture before moving on with life. Until I realized that life is like an error and trial in a science experiment, where if something doesn't go right the first time, you get a second, a third, a fourth, and a fifth chance. Despite that, despite being lost most of the time, I can still find my way sometimes. Sometimes I stop sweating from my hands, my feet, and from the back of my knees. Sometimes I stop looking like I want to pee all the time because I'm so scared. Sometimes I feel calm. Sometimes I feel less lost. You know, I feel like I'm a mix of Monica and Chandler from Friends, where I make really bad puns, but I make really good peanut butter cookies. Remember when Chandler quit his job and didn't know what he wanted to do next with his life, and Monica went from being a chef to a waitress? They still made the best out of the situation that they were in. And so I feel that I become less lost in the little things I do. A, I make my friends laugh till their faces cramp up from the memes I show them. B, I give my family a real-life demonstration of what my hair looks like when I brush it when it's dry, to which my grandma once told me, Mehi, you look like Abul Hul. C, I go to my math teacher every single break. It's not exaggeration, believe me. To discuss the exam and the homework we had to the point where they told me, Mehi, you give me a migraine. And to be honest, before the rehearsals, I was actually working on my math I-8. And when I go home today, I'm gonna continue working on it. D, when someone cuts in front of me in line, I tell them, excuse me, I was here first. And if it doesn't matter who was here first, then you won't mind going to the back of the line. A, B, C, D, E, E, E. Okay. So, I know I love genetics, thanks to Orphan Black. And I know I love animals, thanks to all the documentaries I watched. And so, I know I'll find a major along those lines. Sometimes, I can see around me, and I see people I love. Sometimes, I can see my future, and it's a better and less dramatic version of Grey's Anatomy. I want you to understand that it's okay to be lost. No one, even if someone admits it or not, they're lost. And if they tell you they're not, then they're lying. You and I are lost. Our parents are lost. Do you think that they know what they're doing 80% of the time with us? They're basically winging it with us along the way. And our parents and our teachers are lost too, because sometimes they wake up in the morning and they rethink their decision to teach 20 hyperactive children a day. Our aunts and uncles who want to plan our lives for us and plan who we're going to marry are also lost themselves because they're basically projecting what they wish they would have done in their lives onto us. And our grandparents who are 70 and 80 years old who tell you, "Iskuti habibi ana fahim illi ana baqulu," are also lost because they don't know if they've done enough good in their lives or if they brought our parents up the right way. We have expectations to not be lost, when the people who put these expectations were or are currently lost themselves. You shouldn't be ashamed of being lost. You're not born knowing who you are. You are a stranger to yourself, and you get to know yourself like a friend would throughout the course of life. Just because I'm lost doesn't mean I'm a lost cause, okay? It means that I have to be Sherlock Holmes because the mystery being solved is my life. And along the way, you get to know yourself and you will disrupt the continuous flow of disarray and you'll find something new about yourself, whether it's good or bad, but in that moment, you'll feel like you know yourself. You know, you're like a puzzle, basically. You know, like the really complex ones that's like 5,000 pieces? I really hated those as a kid. You'll feel like you're 11 from Stranger Things because you're scared to go into the upside down, which is life, whether you're 12, 28, 52, 63, or 93. You'll find yourself, homie, okay? No one has their life together 24/7. Don't kid yourself. But don't wait for a savior either. Tug your own hand and keep on going through life. Don't ever stop. Be your own mother of dragons, your own high respecter, Aisha, I'm looking at you, your own Harry Potter, your own Jay-Z, be your own hype squad. Thank you.